Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. To start, I would like to tell you very fast something about my organization, the Product Board for Margarine, Fats and Oils in the Netherlands. It's an organization that is working in the interest of all the companies that are operating in the production chain of vegetable oils and animal fats in the Netherlands. It is funded entirely by the industry itself, and when I give you here this slide, you see the different sectors in the oils and fats economy that are involved in our organization. The Product Board, and you could see this as a kind of a mission statement, is committed to an internationally competitive sector that has taken its social responsibilities seriously. The dossiers that we are working on are mostly long-term, and I mentioned just a few. That is the healthy diet, food safety, sustainability, free trade, and so on. The Dutch oils and fat sector is rather important in the European area. Europe imports about 5 million tons of palm oil, and the Dutch palm oil sector imports from that 5 nearly 2 million tons in the Netherlands. Mr. Chairman, among the dossiers, why sustainability? Because the consumer, and that's our customer, puts sustainability questions and question marks at the production chain of oils and fats, among others for palm oil. And as the market is always right, sustainability has become an important part of the license to operate, to produce. And that's not only the case for palm oil. We see it also in soy, we see it on cotton, we see it with beef, we see it with wood, we see it with fish, and so on and so on. But we have to realize that this license to produce or to operate is given by the market, the consumers, our customers, not by governments. For us, the RSPO is the international standard, because we need standards to set the sustainability agenda. Why RSPO? It answers the sustainability concerns in Europe, and we think the world. It's a multi-stakeholder agreement, and happily we see more and more support, now up to more than 700 companies worldwide and organizations who are organized in this organization. It is representing now more than 10% of the palm oil production in the world, and we think, and we have heard it already today, that it is the most successful sustainability standard in the agriculture commodities. The Dutch sector, but not only the Dutch sector, is committed to sustainable palm oil because, and I said it already, palm oil is very important for the Dutch industry. So the Dutch industry is committed. Dutch industry and Dutch companies were among the first to become RSPO members. We started a new initiative, the Task Force for Sustainable Palm Oil, on which I will come back a little bit later. Another item we are recently working on is to call for the European Union to come up with a zero duty preferential tariff for import of CSPO. I'm happy to say that also our government is supporting our activities on sustainable palm oil through all kinds of initiative, through the Sustainable Trade Initiative that we have in the Netherlands. It is political and financial support. And also, we have to mention, Mr. Chairman, the Dutch civil society organizations, our NGOs, like WWF, Oxfam Novib, Solidaridad, organizations with whom we are cooperating, sometimes after quite a lot of discussions, but we from both sides have a positive attitude to the development of sustainable palm oil. In 2010, Mr. Chairman, we started with the Task Force Sustainable Palm Oil. And with this initiative, we united the palm processors, the users, and the retailers. And our ambition is, by the end of 2015, all palm oil used in the Dutch market will be sustainable. And this year, 2015, just before the break, became a little bit a burden because of the comments. Why not today and wait until 2015? Mr. Chairman, it is not a matter of $1.50. It is a matter of a complicated organizational process to change this ingredient in thousands of products that they are bringing on the market in a way that the consumer can believe you. And that takes some time. And it takes some costs, which, and I can convince you of that, the retailers and the producers in the Netherlands will not find in the market. So it is a burden for them themselves. They are working on it. 2015, in my respect, is still a reasonable objective to reach. I said it already, Mr. Chairman, the challenge is that palm oil is a minor component in many products, and often the presence is not known, certainly not for the consumer. And that's the reason that in this task force, we demand the processors, the producers of end products, and the retailers to take over that responsibility for the market development of sustainable palm oil. The whole sector in the Dutch food industry is involved in this task force. The palm oil refiners, the food and feed companies, the retailers, and all participants are committed. Committed directly, but also as an individual industry through a commitment through the associations involved, as they are stated here on the on this scheme. Being involved in this task force, Mr. Chairman, is not without commitment. The commitment of the members is that they have to translate their activities each year in an action plan. And the activities should be in outreach and communication. We have seminars, we organize communication workshops, we give out fact sheets so that we promote the existence and the continuity of the task force, of the palm oil, the sustainable palm oil. We promote membership of RSPO, and of course the most important, we develop the purchasing of RSPO certified palm oil products. This will be put down in yearly reports. This task force, Mr. Chairman, started in 2010. And from a commitment that was given to concrete actions and results is, of course, the next and more difficult step. We developed the first action plans for the year 2011. These plans are now in operation, and the reporting on that will be in the first quarter of 2012. Then we will understand what the first results in the first year, full operational year of this activity of this task force will have as a result. Apart from these direct activities, we have a number of side effects of the work of this task force. We find more positive attention in the media and in politics for sustainable palm oil. We have an awareness at the industry associations and the companies that they have to take over the ownership of sustainability of palm oil. And through the fact that we are more and more working with other companies in other countries, we see that this kind of activity, the work of trying to emphasize on a task force, is also taken over now in some other countries of Europe. Mr. Chairman, it has been said more today, and it will come up in the next few days, I suppose. RSPO is work in progress, and there are still a number of challenges for RSPO and its members. A very important one, and that is certainly for the consumer areas in which we are, the demand for RSPO certified palm products needs to be further strengthened. And I hope that through the activities of our task force, I will have made it clear that we are working on that. RSPO members and organizations need to remain credible. Mr. Chairman, there are people outside who don't like RSPO. Be aware of that. Greenhouse gas issues need to be addressed. And RSPO needs to develop good systems for smaller end users and for smallholders. The industry needs, in our conviction, one international sustainability standard for palm oil, for food, fuel, and feed. And for us in the Netherlands, Mr. Chairman, RSPO is that standard. I thank you very much.